Hey everyone, my name is Lauren O'Connell and my videos help you to stylize your perfect skincare wardrobe. I do want to point out, I am not naked right now. I'm wearing a dress. It's hard to see. I've been fooling around with the camera and the angles. I'm just on my iPhone and I figured, oh, you know what? I'll just tell you I'm not naked. So take my word for it, or I guess see for yourself. Anyways, this video is super last minute. I'm actually getting ready right now to go out and meet a girlfriend for lunch. And one of the questions I get asked all the time in my comments are, what are the products you use when you're just going out in the day? What's your normal makeup routine? And the thing is, I have so many reviews on my channel showcasing all the different products I like to use, trying things out, doing different routines, and the question still comes up. So I figured, you know what? This is my normal day-to-day makeup. If I was to meet you out for a coffee, this is pretty much how I would show up. So I'm just gonna show you the products I just applied to my face, to my skin, and if you're interested in the ingredients or the application and how I use them, I have videos on everything. So all the ingredients in these products are, of course, amazing. So let's get right into the foundation. This foundation is incredible. To me, the ingredients label reads more as a skincare product than a foundation, but it's this one. It's the Nude Stix Tinted Cover Foundation. And today I'm wearing shade 1.5. I actually have a few different shades. I was going between 1.2 and 1.5, but the 1.5 is definitely my match. Now you can see how my skin, and I am recording this on an iPhone, there are no edits or filters on this video. I haven't brightened this video or done whatever else people are doing these days. I don't even have a ring light on. I'm just in front of a window. But you can see how it just has this beautiful effect on my skin, where my skin still looks like skin. It doesn't look like I'm wearing a mask of foundation, and my face, I can move it. You know what I mean? I don't feel like I have a heavy cake face. So I apply this with a damp beauty blender sponge, and it is my absolute go-to. This is the best foundation I have ever tried. Of course, I do have the full ingredients breakdown in a video, and I'll have it sliding up here somewhere. But I mean, come on. So I also put it all over, not all over, but I put it on my neck and then I blend it into my chest as well, just to make everything look nice and even. Love this foundation. I'm going to be 38 tomorrow, 38 years old. So, you know, I do have some of those fine lines around my eyes, although now I'm using my new face, it's helping a lot, but I don't have any Botox or fillers or any of that stuff. I just like to do a laser treatment once a year, and of course, great skincare. Next up is the concealer. Now, the fine lines under my eyes are my number one biggest skin concern, and there are certain concealers where I swear they make that under eye area look 10 times worse. They dry on me and they kind of fill into those lines, and it almost looks like a, I know I live in Dubai, but it's like the sandy dune. Whenever I go out to the sand dunes and you see those ripples, they kind of remind me of how my eye area would look if I use a bad concealer. The only concealer I like is this one. This is the Tarte Creaseless Concealer. Of course, I have the reviews on this one as well, but it's thick, which is surprising because you would think you don't want a thick concealer there. Trust me, it is dewy and it just does, it never settles into those lines. It keeps the under eye area so hydrated and bright that it doesn't matter if I put this on at 9 a.m. At 4 p.m., I'm still okay. I'm not self-conscious. I don't need to go into the bathroom and go like this under my eye area. It really does look good all day long. This is an incredible, incredible product, full of the best ingredients possible. So after I apply my foundation and my concealer, I always want to set it with just a touch of powder. And I truly mean a touch. I don't want to put a lot of powder on my face because I have dry skin, and it's going to, one, soak up the moisture that I definitely need to stay there, but also it's just going to age me. It's going to make me look older. Now I'm struggling here because I can't get this open. One minute. All right, I just had to have my husband open it for me. He's on a business call right now and the loose powder went all over him. And he just gave me this look of, are you serious? So this is the powder, it's by Fenty Beauty and it is just a loose powder. I think that this truly is made for women with maturing skin because this powder does not sink in to the fine lines, the marionette lines, the crow's feet, or anything. I put a very light, and I'm telling you, light dusting on my face. This lasts forever. And it just does help to soak up that extra shine, but not too much. So my skin still, you can see my skin still looks dewy. It still looks like skin. The one thing that I'm not too crazy about with this powder is it is lightly fragranced. And if you follow any of my content, you know that I am pretty much against fragrance in skincare and cosmetic products. This is the one of the very few occasions I let it slide only because the powder itself is just so good on my skin. I use it very sparingly and I have not found it to really be detrimental to my skin's health at all. When I'm out, so say if we're having a coffee and you know, we're gonna take a selfie. And some of my girlfriends, they are selfie queens. I always bring this with me. If you don't have one of these, get one. Oh, it's so good, I'm gonna show you why. I do have a review on this as well, somewhere on my channel. But it's just a powder compact. Oh, this is my old one. You can see how much I used it. I guess that shows you I really do like it. And what's so great about it is it has this nice little brush. You know, a lot of the compacts have the sponge. I don't like the sponges because they don't look, the makeup just doesn't look good on the skin. This one, light dusting, and then I mean ever so light dusting on my face. And what I also love about it is that it's so slim. It fits very, very nicely into a clutch, especially if I'm going out in the evening. I mean, there's not much to it, doesn't take up too much space, and it does a great job of just covering up that shininess, but at the same time, it does have a blurring effect to it. There is some little microfine shimmer particles. So it, once again, it just gives you that sort of goddess glow, which is what I always go for. Let's talk about bronzer. Now, the bronzer I'm using is this one. This is by Charlotte Tilbury, shade 2. And you can see this is going to last me a very long time. It's very similar, if not the same shade, to the palette that Charlotte Tilbury has that has the bronzer and the highlighter in it. This just is a nice big bronzer with a nice big mirror. And this is what I have on my skin right now. You can see it does just kind of warm up my complexion a bit and give me that nice definition. And once again, it is a little bit more on the pricey side, but once you buy it, this is going to last you forever. Moving on to blush, I always like my cheeks to have enough blush on it to bring just some color to my skin because I am so fair. And basically, if I'm not wearing blush, people are gonna say, are you not feeling well? You look kind of pale. And I'm just like, no, this is how I look. But this is blush is by Tarte. This is called Doll Face. It looks quite pink here, but when you see it on my face, I think it just gives me a very natural, healthy look. For my eyeshadow, I like my eyes just to be pretty nude throughout the day. And I'm finding lately, even for nighttime, I'll do just a darker nude type of eye. But the two palettes that I love are this one. This is the Tartlet in Bloom. And this is pretty much one of my go-to palettes. I've probably been through about 4 of them. So I do have one that I need to throw out. I've hit pan on almost every single shade. But you can see it's just a nice assortment of nudes. I'm sorry, it's a little bit messy, but you can see, hey, she does use it. And you can go really dark with it too. And I find that the shades blend incredibly well. That's why I keep buying this because I hate buying those dry type of eyeshadow palettes where you get no, I mean, you end up like, you know, getting more muscle from all the blending that's going on. And then I also do like this Charlotte Tilbury palette. This was a limited edition one. I'm not sure if it's still available for sale. I hope so, because I'm showing you guys. And I hate it when I show something and then I get the comments of, where do I buy it? And I realize, ugh, I just showed something that's not for sale anymore. This is the Starry Eyes to Hypnotize palette. So I really like to use these two, and you can see I'm using them today on my eyes. And I mean, this truly is a day-to-day look because I'm not even wearing any eyeliner on top. I just like my eyes to be a bit more open during the day. So the mascara I use is this one by Too Faced. It's the Damn Girl Mascara, and my secret eyelash weapon, because let me tell you, my eyelashes are pretty unremarkable. Actually, my son asked me the other day, where was that device I used to cut my eyelashes? And I said, what? And he said to me, Mom, where's that thing you put on your eyes to cut your eyelashes? And I said, are you talking about my eyelash curler? And I showed it to him and he said, yes. And I said, this is to curl my eyelashes. He said, oh, I always thought you used it to cut your eyelashes. And that's why you have such short eyelashes. He said, because I need to cut mine. They're too long and I look like a girl. Can you believe that? He's 9 years old and he was dead serious. He really thought that I trimmed my eyelashes. That boy, let me tell you. Anyways, so you can see I just have very normal, very boring eyelashes. So this product, this Dior primer, what it does is when I curl, it really holds on to that curl. It's almost like a hairspray for the eyelashes. And then it stiffens them up a bit, and then I apply this on top while this is still wet. And I apply about 2 or 3 good coats of this, and that's how I get any bit of volume, depth, length that I have. Otherwise, they are pretty unremarkable, as noticed by my son. So last up for the lips, one of the lipsticks I just love to use throughout the day because it's very pretty, natural, and hydrating is this one. This is by Laura Mercier. The color is called A La Rose, and it really is just a pink. And it's pretty, it's not bright, it's not neon, it's not that pastel pink that always reminds me of the movie Something About Mary. If you're born in the 80s, you know that movie. And then I put this one on top. This is the Marc Jacobs lip gloss. And I do have reviews on this one too. This color is called Enamored. And it does have some microfine shimmer in it, but I think that that just kind of makes my lips look a little bit bigger, a little bit plumper, which I like because I just have very average size lips. So it's nice for them to look a little bit fuller. So this is truly my day-to-day makeup routine. If I'm not filming YouTube videos and I'm just kind of going out and about, if I'm going to a beauty event during the day, this is pretty much what I would use. I did forget one product. Let me just show you. This is the eyeliner I like. It's by Tom Ford and it's called Tourmaline. It's a blue eyeliner. And because I have green eyes, I like to use a little bit of blue underneath because it kind of makes them pop out a little bit more. And it makes my eyes look a little bit bigger. And it makes my eyes look a little bit greener too. If I use a black eyeliner or a dark brown, they're just going to look smaller. Now, if you're wondering, what does Lauren use every night on her skin? By all means, check out my video right here on my evening skincare routine.